So student, now we are going to start the chemical properties of metal, in which we are discussing about metal and non-metals. So here we are, in order to understand the chemical properties of metals, okay, metals. Okay, so first we had to discuss the displacement reaction. Which reaction? The displacement reaction. Okay, so displacement reaction is nothing but when, you know, one metal displaces another metal from its salt, then it is called as displacement reaction. Then it is called as displacement reaction. Okay, so here we have the definition. First we will discuss definition and then we will discuss about the examples. Okay, so more reactive metals, see, sometimes what happens, more reactive metal replaces the less reactive metal from its compound, okay, then it is called as displacement reaction. So here we have the more reactive element displaces a less reactive element from its compound or a solution is called as displacement reaction. Understood what is displacement reaction? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we have to understand the example. See, here if we will check first reaction, here we have the zinc. Zn is what? It is the zinc. When it is treated with copper sulfate, CuSO4 is the copper sulfate. So in reaction we have zinc plus copper sulfate, CuSO4. So here if we will check the reactivity of zinc and copper, zinc is more reactive than copper. So what zinc will do? Zinc will replace that copper from its salt. Okay, so zinc will form ZnSO4 and copper will get removed out from here. So the product will be ZnSO4 and copper will get separated out. Okay, so what happens here? This is the compound of the less reactive metal, and when we are treating it with the more reactive metal, it replaces the less reactive metal from its compound and forms its own salt or compound. This reaction is called as displacement reaction. Understood what is displacement reaction?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here we have one more example. If we will check the reactivity of aluminium and ferrous, so aluminium is more reactive than ferrous. Okay, so what aluminium will do? Aluminium will replace the ferrous from its oxide to form aluminium oxide, and ferrous will get separated out at a molten state. Molten means at a liquid state. Okay, so this is all about the displacement reaction. Okay, this is the first
reaction. Ferrum will be the residue, no sir?
It's not ferrum, it is ferrous, iron. It is ferrous. It is not residue, it is another byproduct. The byproduct. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So now we are going to discuss the second reaction, which is the metal reaction of metal with oxygen. Okay, so here I'm writing, wait a second, I'm just using the screen, wait a second. We will discuss reaction here. Okay, so second reaction we are going to discuss, which is the reaction of metal or metals with oxygen. Okay, so first, see, generally what happens when metal reacts with oxygen, okay, it forms metal oxide. Metal oxide. Understood? When metal reacts with oxygen, gives metal oxide. This is the general reaction. Okay, now we will have to understand with the example now. So can we write description over here? I am writing description here. When metals reacts with oxygen, gives metal oxide. Okay, this is a description for the reaction. When metal reacts with oxygen, gives metal oxide. Okay, so we have to understand with the help of example. So first, suppose we have sodium metal, and sodium is very reactive. When you will treat sodium with oxygen, okay, so sodium will going to form Na2O. Okay, and how will you decide that what will be the product? So we know sodium have valency 1, okay, and oxygen have valency 2. Okay, so we have to cross multiply the valencies of the combining element. Okay, so we will have 1 oxygen and 2 sodium. So the product will be Na2O. See, here we have Na2O, it is sodium oxide. But here we have 2 oxygen atom, but in product side we have only 1. So we have to multiply here by 2. So now total oxygen will be 2. But sodium we have 2, 2s are 4. But here we have only 1. So here we have to multiply by 4. Okay. So now the balance reaction is 4 of sodium reacts with oxygen gas in order to form 2 molecules of Na2O, sodium oxide. Okay. So I have to write the name. So it is sodium. It is oxygen. Here we have sodium oxide. Okay. So if you want to write description for this reaction, you can write it as, let me write for you. When sodium reacts with oxygen, gives sodium oxide. Okay, so this is the description for the above reaction. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now take a screenshot, beta, everyone. And you have to make your own notes also by writing whatever I am, asking you to take a screenshot. Okay, you have to write that displacement reaction also. Understood, everyone? Okay, take a screenshot, beta. Okay. So here we have discussed about the basic oxides of metal. Here, some metallic oxide, when they dissolve in water, they produces OH negative ion. That's why those metallic oxide are called as basic or alkali. Okay. And their aqueous solution turns the red litmus paper into blue color, and this is the taste of basic substance. Okay, that means metallic oxide, they behaves like the base. Now we are going to discuss about the amphoteric oxides of metal. So any idea what are amphoteric oxide? Yes.
No, sir, can you repeat the question?
What are amphoteric oxide?
I don't know, sir.
Okay, I'll explain, don't worry. Okay, so I'm writing definition over here. Oh, it is given here. Amphoteric oxide are the metal oxide, okay, They are the metal oxide, which react with both acid as well as base to form salt and water, are called as amphoteric oxide. Base, those metal oxide, they react with acids as well as base. And when they react with acid or base both the time, they form salt and water. Okay? And if they form salt and water, that means what? Means what? They are, yes, they are basic in nature. Okay? We have just understood that. Okay? So, most of the, you know, like metallic oxide, not most of the, few of the metallic oxide, they react with acid as well as base. And when they react with acid or base, they form salt and water. And such metallic oxides are called as amphoteric oxide. Or called as amphoteric oxide. Understood, everyone?
Sir, can you explain this part again?
Okay. So, wait a second. I'll... Okay. Suppose I'm writing heading first, amphoteric oxide. Amphoteric oxide. So those metal oxide which reacts with acid as well as base are called as amphoteric. Base to form salt and water. Are called as amphoteric oxide.
There are metal oxides like gases.
Wait a second. Yes, if they are at a, you know, a very high temperature, then they are at a gaseous state. Okay.
Where do we get them?
Suppose you are having that magnesium or copper, and if you will burn them, okay, then they will convert into the gaseous form. But after some time, these particles are very heavy in air, so they get settled down in the form of solid. Okay? So, amphoteric oxide. So, what are amphoteric oxide? Those metallic oxide, they react with acid as well as base to form salt and water are called as amphoteric oxide. Suppose, I'm taking example, Al2O3. It is aluminium oxide. And suppose it reacts with HCl. It is hydrochloric acid. So, not HCl, with water. HCl. We have to take HCl. It is acid. Okay. So, they will form AlOH thrice. Aluminium. We already written over here. See, when Al2O3, okay, reacts with, this is Al2O3, when it reacts with HCl, it gives aluminium chloride and along with water. Okay, see, aluminium chloride is nothing but the salt and that of water. H2O is water. So, this is a salt and water are formed. That means, here neutralization reaction takes place. Okay, now another example, suppose we have Al2O3, it is again aluminium oxide. When it reacts with sodium hydroxide and it is the base, okay, they are going to form NaAlO2. It is sodium meta-aluminate, and water will form. See, every time water is being formed, okay? Now, that's why if water is, get out released during the reaction, then it is called as dehydrolysis reaction. Dehydrolysis reaction. D means removal of, hydrolysis means water. So the removal of water in any reaction, they are called as dehydrolysis reaction. Okay, now, again, we have one more example of zinc oxide, ZnO. Okay, see here. Zinc oxide, when react with HCl, gives ZnCl2. ZnCl2. It is zinc chloride and water is being formed. Okay. Next, this is reaction with acid. Now we will check reaction with base. So here ZnO, it is zinc oxide, reacts with sodium hydroxide. Okay. So sodium hydroxide is the base. So when it reacts with base, gives sodium zincate. It is sodium zincate along with water is being formed. So in each reaction, we have gone through that when metal oxide, like few of metal oxide, they are amphoteric in nature, they react with acid as well as base to form salt and water, are called as amphoteric oxide. Very simple. Understood, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so again, I want you all to take a screenshot for that. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, any doubt, Vida?
No, sir.
Sure, na? Time? What is reactivity series? See, the reactivity series is nothing but the arrangement of metals. Okay? It is nothing but the arrangement of metals in increasing or decreasing order of their reactivity in the form of series is called as reactivity series. Okay, understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have to go through that notes that we have prepared for. Okay, so this is reactivity series. See, at the top of the series, most reactive elements are present. Here, most reactive. And here we have least reactive. And in between, we have moderate reactive. Moderately reactive metals. Okay. This series is called as reactivity series. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Again, I want you to take a screenshot for that. Wait a second. Yeah. Take a screenshot, Bita. Done? Have you taken screenshot, everyone? Everyone, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Is your replying very late, Amitam? I used to ask like 4, 5, 6 times, and then you are replying. Huh? It shouldn't be there, no? Okay. So, any doubt in reactivity series?
No, sir.
No, no? Okay. So, have you downloaded notes from your WhatsApp group, this one? Huh? Yes?
sir. What did you ask, sir?
I have shared that notebook, notes on your WhatsApp group, last to last lecture. When I think you are from another batch, no? Then you have came on the second batch, B.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so beta, I am going to post this notes right now, and you have to go through that notes also, huh?
Yes, sir.
Wait a second, I have to share this notes with you.